Hey, we are back again with another interesting topic. We have Dr. Raju Indukuri sir with us to discuss on specializations in MBA. Hello, sir.
Hi.
Last time we had a chat on masters and the ones who are aspiring to pursue masters. So I could figure out that I would like to join MBA.
So now you made your mind.
Yeah.
Good, very good.
So
congratulations.
Thank you. So MBA, when I specifically want to join MBA, there are many specializations in it. I broadly want to know what kind of specializations and which specializations are good for what.
Okay, so first of all, you said you are in BTech Civil Engineering, right?
Yeah.
So BTech Civil Engineering is one vertical, one specialization.
Yeah.
Similarly, in MBA or PGDM or PGPM, whatever you call it as, Masters in Management, we have several verticals as specializations.
Yeah.
Among them, you have Finance, Marketing, HR, IT, International Business, Tourism, Hospitality. There are several verticals. It's quite common. So, it's nothing new that MBA has specializations.
Mm-hmm.
Like any science or arts or commerce, management also has specializations.
Yeah.
So, sorry, what was the question?
Like what are the specializations in MBA?
I think that's what I said.
Yeah.
I already listed that.
Yeah, so I am not aware of what exactly they are. I know there are verticals in them.
Okay, maybe there are several verticals, but popular are of finance, Marketing, Human Resources Management, popularly known as HR.
Okay.
These are the three specializations most of the students try to take
okay.
in India.
Okay, can you just like elaborate them or describe them?
I will just summarize, okay. First of all, HR is people management. Marketing is all about promoting business, promoting product, branding, and so on. And there is a slight difference between sales and marketing. Okay, they're definitely different, but it is very difficult to understand for a fresher.
Mm-hmm.
Then finance is all about working with investments, lending, borrowing, companies, how they borrow, how they lend, then financial services. And there is a huge difference between finance and accounting. They're completely different.
Yeah.
So finance is finance, accounting is accounting.
Okay.
That's how these three are.
Okay. So I see you have chosen finance in your early years. Can you just tell me what interested you to choose finance?
See, I think this kind of, I did my master's in management in 1997. Andhra University awarded me. At that time this kind of technology, openness, information, internet, these kind of things are not there.
Yeah.
But like you guys, I'm also lost what to do. When I compared, I think same thing, HR, finance, marketing are there.
Yeah.
But I could find out finance is a little challenging for me. So I wanted to take the challenging one so that subject is challenging means it will be demanded more by the industry. If it is easy means there are less people to demand.
Okay.
Maybe pay also will be more for that. Like that I thought, number one. Number two, that time I was part of my business. My dad has a business. So I thought of finance will give me more inputs to inculcate into the business. That is how I have chosen finance. At that time, there is only one specialization I have to take. But nowadays, people are offering dual specializations. Most of the B schools, universities, they are offering dual specializations. They can take two specializations
okay.
equally. Some B schools offer as a minor and major.
Mm-hmm.
Say, for example, they have taken one and two specialization. They take more subjects in first specialization, that becomes major.
Okay.
Less number of subjects in the other specialization, that becomes minor.
Okay.
They can also take equally.
Okay.
The different program structure is designed.
What kind of, like, as you spoke about subjects, what kind of subjects are included in finance?
In finance, you have variety of subjects. It's very difficult to answer. You have a number of subjects. But typically, subjects like security analysis and portfolio management, financial institutions, financial markets and services, mergers and acquisitions, international finance, then these are very old traditional papers. But in addition to that, there are many other papers like banking, insurance, financial planning, wealth management, investment management, valuation of securities, portfolio management, fixed income securities. There are many corporate valuation and mergers, fintech and cryptocurrency, foreign currency derivatives, risk management. There are many mutual funds. There are many specializations offered.
I know this is a wrong question being asked to you, but I have many of my seniors now who are pursuing MBA. So they probably tell us that if you want to pursue MBA, if you want to study MBA, prefer marketing, or finance is too tough, take marketing. Is that real? What is it exactly? Is that a myth, or is it exactly what it is?
Okay, I'll put your views as a question.
Okay.
Maybe you're trying to ask which specialization to take.
Yeah.
So I think that is a big problem. Like in my earlier talk with you, I told you why MBA, why should you do MBA? You should be very clear why you're taking MBA. If that is clear, which specialization to take will be very clear.
Okay.
There is no ambiguity at all.
Mm-hmm.
The reason here is students don't take MBA because they wanted to do something. They got rank, parents told, friends told, they just joined into MBA. So once they finish second semester, they think about which specialization. And as you rightly mentioned, let us not take finance, let us get into marketing, theory paper, it is easy for us, finance, problems are there, finance, accounting is there, finance, numbers are there, you know, that is very wrong, okay. See, I think I gave you a long list of courses, okay. To the matter of fact, syllabus could be the same, but the rigor varies from B school to B school. Okay, at the university level with affiliated college kind of thing, the rigor is different compared to B school or like IIMs or IITs kind of thing. Okay, so in that fact, in that way, all subjects are quantitative. Let it be human resources management, marketing management, financial management, anything, HR, marketing, finance. So people are well equipped irrespective of your qualification. In your undergraduation, okay? So MBA program in the first year trains the students so that the students become good in quantitative decisions. So in that way, every subject is quantitative.
Yeah.
It's not just marketing easy, finance tough, HR easy, marketing tough. Maybe one way, female students like you, they hate sales. Some students say, some. I'm not saying all. Sir, I don't want to get into marketing, I need to travel, you know, I need to move out. Maybe that is the case, it is, yeah, agreed point. But if you say, my undergraduation is this, I can't do that, that has numbers, I don't want to do that. And one more thing is, based on the faculty, people try to choose a specialization.
Mm-hmm.
That is a weird thing. You're killing yourself, you're cheating yourself, okay? You like some faculty. If that faculty is in finance, you try to take finance as a specialization.
Yeah.
You hate some faculty, right? And you don't like to take that specialization. That is very, very wrong.
Mm.
That faculty will not be there with you for the rest of the life. Okay, yeah. But the knowledge you acquire, it will be there with you forever. Please understand that.
Yeah.
These things are okay, very good reasons. Yeah. And there are other silly reasons. My mom told, dad told, my uncle told, my friends told, my seniors told, okay, my faculty told. What? See, everyone is there to tell you because you are asking.
Yeah.
Please understand. Without asking also, some people may tell you. But they are just the inputs. But it is you who have to decide on what is my specialization.
Yeah.
It all depends on your interest, passion, capacity, your ability to do, your undergraduation, moreover your comfort zone.
Yeah.
And this should be connected to your career goal.
Yeah.
Let it be business or job. Okay? So if one this kind of a professional track is there in your thinking pattern, I think things are quite easy.
Okay.
There is no subject like easy or there is no subject like tough. Okay. Some students, when I taught them, a few students are from BTech, like a hardcore quant guys. Sir, I can do any kind of a problem, but marketing and human resources manager, I have to write a lot of papers. It's very tough for me. I'm not getting marks.
Mm-hmm.
That was his mindset.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's nothing like, let it be HR, marketing or finance, all are equal. But what is your priority? That you only will know.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
That's how it goes.
Yeah.
Don't be carried away with your friend's decisions.
Yeah.
I think one point I told you, it depends on your undergraduation also. For example, if you are a commerce guy,
mm-hmm.
you will have an advantage if you take finance as a specialization.
Okay.
Why? Because in finance, there are finance and accounting jobs,
mm-hmm.
public sector companies,
mm-hmm.
and corporate companies.
Okay.
They ask for MBA finance guy preferred with commerce, BCom or MCom or CE or ICWA.
Mm-hmm.
There you have the advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Say for example, MBA, there is one specialization IT.
Okay.
Okay? MBA IT. If a BTech computer science students take MBA IT, you have a huge advantage.
Yeah.
You can get into business analyst kind of jobs.
Mm-hmm.
You can get into cryptocurrency, fintech.
Yeah.
So that's how your undergraduation will also help you. But your undergraduation cannot dictate your specialization. It's your interest.
Mm-hmm.
Because MBA doesn't say you should do MBA if you're BCom, if you're BSc, if you're BA, BTech. Anyone can do MBA.
Yeah.
Anyone can take any specialization.
Yeah. Your answer has even clarified me. Like where people say you need a certain background to enter a certain specialization.
That is the funniest part. Sir, I don't have any sales experience. How can I take marketing? Yeah, you're fresher. You didn't do any job. Sir, I don't have any commerce or accounting experience. How can I how can I take finance specialization? That's wrong.
Now I realize that's a myth.
Yeah.
So, thank you so much, sir.
My pleasure. Once again.
For having a great talk with us. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.